No bacon?
It's just a green salad, Pop.
Yeah, but bacon livens up a salad.
Bacon makes everything better.
Yeah. We've got fried chicken and cheddar biscuits and mac and cheese, and you're missing the bacon.
So,
rule number 9 to live by. You can eat whatever you want as long as it has green salad next to it.
Yeah.
Not french fries.
You should put that in the patrol guide.
Really? It's reached the DA's office?
What's reached where?
Anthony got wind of it, so you can imagine his reaction.
I can.
There's talk of a physical standard for cops' fitness, like a test.
Also known as discrimination.
Oh, come on, Pop.
Jack Axelrod, my chief of D's.
Yeah.
He closed his weight in major cases.
And bought the farm before he reached retirement age.
Okay, I'll give you that. But he would have been a great loss if I'd had to fire him because he was husky.
Husky. Exactly how fat is husky?
I'm not talking about Navy SEAL shape, Pop. But being able to run up a few flights of stairs, you bet.
You're trapped in a fire on the 3rd floor. You're praying that the firefighters can run up there. It's the same thing.
Exactly.
Well, you're preaching the choir here, but how do you legislate that?
It's just setting a minimum standard.
I know, but what if you got one cop who's quick on his feet? But then there's another cop who, when she pulls up to a crime in progress, she's got like x-ray vision, but then yet another cop who can disarm and defuse a standoff like he's singing a lullaby. I mean, which one of those cops would we want to lose because they're out of shape?
I hate to admit it, but he has a point.
Becomes a slippery slope.
No. Danny hit it right on the nose.
In a perfect world, all 3 of those cops could run up a flight of stairs and climb over a fence.
And when you find a perfect world, please, tell me the address.